happens. But what happens is there's like a spotlight. If you think of someone, you know, doing a play on stage and they got the white spotlight shined on them and they're the only ones you can see at that moment, that's kind of the way it is, because the leader can see everybody clearly. He or she wants to know, you know, who's on board, who's supporting change, who's embracing change, who's going to be leading change, and is there anybody out there that wants to champion change and help at that level with the leader? And so what's going to happen, though, as soon as change happens at work, the way you deal with it, whether it's proactive or reactive, it's going to increase or decrease your influence. If you deal with it proactively, that means you're going to be part of the solution. You're going to help the leader figure out how do we make this happen and understand why the leader's doing it, why the organization's doing it, and the win in it. Look for the positive in it. Proactive people look for the positive in the change.
People have the perception or impression that being proactive means taking the initiative. And sure, that could be a part of being proactive. But really, for me, the best way to understand what proactive really means is to dig into what reactive really means. And you touched on it there, Mac. But, you know, being reactive means we respond to something based on our feelings and our emotions in the moment. Now, we're all human. We all have feelings and emotions. There's nothing wrong with that. It's Andy Stanley, however, who reminds us our feelings are terrible leaders. And that's so powerful when change happens, because most of the time there are feelings of fear or worry or uncertainty, or, hey, I just don't like what's coming down the pipe. And so I want to be angry about it or frustrated with it. Right? Now, we're human. Those emotions are going to naturally occur sometimes in some situations, but we don't have to react to them. Right?